Right then. Let's kick this off then, eh? Once upon a time, yeah. Okay. Well, let me tell you about getting fucked over by your demons. Eventually they're gonna catch up with you. Tear you to pieces. Let me tell you about him and her. And her and him. These poor, good people. And what happened to them. It's quite sad, really, to see how it all ended up. How they all ended up. Pulped on the floor in that god-awful fucking place. Their guts spewed, hanging out, dissected, dismembered. Deceased. Fucking dead. Fucked. It didn't end up good. Didn't end up good, you know. That's a fucking understatement. They meant the best for me, but real life doesn't have a happy ending. At least they don't have to live in it. Because if there's one true victim to be had from all of this, I'll be perfectly honest with you. It's me. It is me. My name's Nick West, by the way. We should rewind here. I want to tell you how it began, so innocently. No one understood, no one knew how deep all this ran. I really want to tell you how it all went down. If you stick with me, I promise you it'll be worth your while.
Yeah, I did.
This is Sammy. Hot fucking Sammy. Sweet, sweet girl. Fucking beautiful. Sexy. Filthy.
We're gonna get off our fucking nut.
But I won't bore you with the details, because she's not going to be around long enough for them to matter, really.
She's that arse of yours.
I guess you've seen Hellraiser. I'm guessing you've seen all those kinds of films. Oh, Pumpkinhead, yeah. Or whatever. It's probably why you're watching this now. But after what happened and what we found that day, well, I wish I'd shown a little more interest, you know? Paid more attention. I might have learned something.
Nice.
Welcome to the asylum, baby. I do what I can, you know?
First impressions? Fucking shithole.
So what do you think of this place? I guess the cleaner must have pulled a suit here.
Cunt's dead.
Yeah. Cunt must be dead.
Stupid bitch.
Why are you so vexed about this?
I wouldn't say family was easy, you know? But she wasn't exactly hard to crack either. You know, a couple of drinks. A few tabs, you stand a good chance of a happy ending.
I'm meant to cunt, aren't you? Got something for you.
We showed a zipper.
Why don't you take a look at these?
What's that?
That's a little piece of magic, baby.
Acid? Come on, Nick, not here.
Come on. Open your fucking mouth. I'll stick a knife in your ass. You won't be able to sit down for 6 weeks.
Okay.
Tom. One for you. And one for me. You're so fucking beautiful. And you're fucking filthy too. What are you doing with that? Anything like me?
I like weirdos.
I like the fact you like weirdos. Come on, let's go see how fucking crazy this place is now. What the fuck?
What is that?
Now that's the fucking reason why we came here.
Is that real?
Fucking ready, Ted.
Wait, I know. It's a fucking chair. Big deal, right? And all I can say is things aren't always what they seem.
Get in it. Go on.
That's weird.
Sit in it. Go on, get in it.
This is all the mentals used to get there, bruh. Shut up, sweet.
Let me tie you down.
So beautiful. So, so beautiful.
Get my cock out. Shut up.
Look at her, the dirty little mutter. Sucking me till the 12th and never.
I wanna go, come on, let me have a go.
I'll be the Marquis. Be my little slut. I'm gonna fuck your mouth. Fuck your mouth.
The moment before it all changed forever. The moment before life fucked me once and for all and ripped out whatever was left of my heart. However you want to say it, it was fucked. It was stamped on. It was done. Then bang! It all got really fucking weird.
Baby.
Fuck this. Everything from here now is kind of hazy. Like a nightmare or a fever dream. Bits and pieces, that's all I got. Bits and pieces, that's all I got. Blood all over my hands, all over my clothes. Sammy missing and me in the middle of it all, ranting and raving about a chair. It's not a big equation. It all adds up to an indefinite stay in hospital. Have a guess what? Me, Nick West. I'm criminally insane. Apparently. Pills. Ugh. Pills I got in here make acid look like aspirin. Just say no, don't do drugs. Knock them back and swallow. Don't ask questions. Hi, my name's Nick West. I'm medicated. How are you? I've been inside for 4 years. 4 years of pills and bullshit. Rotting in a room because they don't believe me.
Nick.
Haven't seen it for themselves, so it can't be true, yeah? I wish they were right. I wish I was crazy, then there'd be one less psycho on the streets, right? And you'd feel safe in your beds. Only we know that's not the truth. The truth is you're all in danger. When you're trapped in a cell that long, you think you're alone, forgotten. But I wasn't. Turns out he was watching me, observing me, pulling my strings, and then one day he turned the key, pushed a button. They opened the doors and let the world in, or me out, I'm not sure.
And how do you feel these days, Nick?
I feel healthy. I feel okay.
And nowadays?
They come and go.
What about the stories you told the police? How do you feel about those?
I've learned they were my mind's responses to the stress of what happened. It's not uncommon for people to create fantasies in times of trauma.
What do you think the trauma was?
I know I'm guilty. There's no other explanation. I just have no memory of what happened.
None at all. That bothers you.
Of course it does.
He was acquitted of murder. He's been a model patient for 4 years. Never putting a foot out of line. Surely you don't think he's dangerous.
To others, no, but to himself, quite possibly, he's suffering severe delusions.
Once, 4 years ago, never since.
Not very happy about this. He told
me... I'm not asking you to just set him loose on the world. I'm asking you to put him into my care so we can find out what happened to Sammy. Think about her family. They deserve to know.
And you will take full responsibility for the consequences?
Just show me where to sign.
Sign here, walk free. Doesn't matter that we think you killed someone.
West?
They didn't think very much of me, sending one guy.
I'm here to give you a lift, sir.
Now I'm gonna get the bus.
You're not gonna get a bus round here, sir. Look, why don't you come with me, sir? Come on, let's get you in the car.
Just like that, I was gone.
Where are we going?
Oh, I'm taking you to meet someone, sir.
Thank you. Fucking puns. Welcome to Cambridge.
Here we are then, sir. Just there, Knock and go in. The doctor is expecting you, sir.
Doctor who?
Dr. Willard, sir. Just go in.
Go, Gandalf, slut. He's half pedo, don't you know?
Melissa, leave us alone, will you? Mr. West and I have some business to discuss. She's a little worried, leaving me alone with you. Silly thing.
Why am I here?
Very well. You have been released, but under certain conditions.
What conditions?
I'm writing a book.
Well, do you need a typist?
Oh! No. I need a subject. You, Mr. West.
You want to write a book about me?
Absolutely. Your situation provides me with a fairly unique opportunity. I want to study you and your psychotic episode where the episode itself took place.
What do you mean?
The Blackwater Asylum. You are to travel there with me. Arrangements have been made. The possibilities of this on the study have got my publisher really very excited.
You don't know what you're doing. I can't go back there.
Oh, I'm afraid you can. Unless you want to return to the asylum.
That's blackmail.
Yes. I'm simply asking for a few days of your time in exchange for answers to questions that plague you daily. Is that too much to ask? Ah, perfect timing. Nick West. Rachel Fowles.
First impressions? Fuck me. New mission, get her out of that fucking outfit. First add-on in 4 years.
Pleased to meet you, Nick.
Rachel is one of my brightest psychology students. she's going to be helping me with the study.
So, Nick, it's really great that you're helping us with this.
Great for who?
So, I guess Brett's running late.
Shit. Sorry I'm late.
First impressions? Well, look at the cunt. Tosser. Flatline tosser.
Brett Wilson, how's it going?
Brett, this is Nick.
Nick?
Nick West.
Oh, yes. I went to school with a Nick West, but I imagine it wasn't you.
Brett, come on.
What? That was funny.
Cock.
Come on, just be nice.
Where's your sense of humour?
He's had a really tough time, okay?
Oh, has he?
Dr. Willard.
All right, that's enough. Melissa will be waiting outside in the car. Come on.
Oh, my brothers. It really was this ridiculous. Like a bad Scooby-Doo. 5 hours of countryside and educated nothingness. Fine art and the theatre, croquet and carrot cake. houses in France and stuff that could never mean anything to me. Can they not hear themselves? The banal conversations floating through the air like feces smeared across a crusty sky. Sad bunch of vacuous little cunts. With their private school educations, strong, perfect parents. Silver spoon-fed failed models preening, perfect, empty. Clueless clown. Poor little me. And Gandalf. I'm not okay, Big Tits.
Yeah.
This is gonna be easier than you think. Just whenever you're ready, all right?
Careful where you tread.
No shit. Looks like the maid died. What?
Memories washing over me like a fever. Making my head spin. I started to sweat. Thought I was gonna throw up. It was a real fucking trip and I wasn't having any fun.
Classic. He's having flashbacks.
Maybe we should follow him.
He's filming the camera.
Dr. Willard, we could follow him and get his reaction. Yeah. What's this?
Tell me something, Willard. Am I the only one slightly concerned that we've returned to the scene of the murder with the murderer?
A lot of memories in this place.
Something like that.
You can talk to me, you know. Tell me what happened.
I don't know anymore.
It's all right. Come on, let's get back to the others.
Now, I suggest we eat and discuss our reasons for being here.
Yes, sir.
if you could organize the food.
I'll fetch the hamper from the car.
I'm just going to take you and Rachel and show you the room upstairs. Excuse me, Nick, if you don't mind waiting here. This is where the incident supposedly took place. At his worst point, he claimed that that was what took his girlfriend.
So you know all about why you're here?
I know bits and pieces that he tells me.
What did he tell you about me?
He didn't have to. I know what you are.
So you think I'm a murderer, do you?
I didn't say that.
Where were you? I'd stay well away from me.
Dr. Willard wouldn't put me in any danger.
He already has.
Onto this.
What are you doing?
Setting down. What does it look like?
Right.
What? Mr. Wilson, get up from there. That is not a plaything.
It's perfectly safe, I'm sure. I mean, how old is it?
Right. Dr. Willard!
Wilson, I am quickly tiring of your nonsense. Get up out of that damn chair.
It's not for me.
Mr. Wilson, perhaps you could use up some of that energy setting up the work lights.
Bread! Bread! You're on fire, Bread!
Won't be laughing for long. I never dreamt I'd spend another night in that place. But day turned to night pretty fast, and where was I gonna go? I was a dog on a leash with a cruel master.
One more left.
Never been afraid of the dark. I was always more afraid of the light. I didn't want to see what was going to happen. If you can't see what's coming for you, maybe you can't see you either.
Oh, we have light. Here you go.
Don't all thank me at once.
Good work, Brett. Where's Dr. Willard?
No idea. You want some of this?
Well, don't you think we should wait for the doctor?
Why? Is he the barman? Do you want some of this?
I knew what was coming. Needed to keep my wits about me, stay sharp. If he was smart, he'd do the same. The last thing you want to be is liquored up when the shit comes down, and it would come down.
No? Come on, man. It's bloody freezing outside.
I'm mixing my medication.
Thank you for the light, Mr. Wilson. It's wonderful. Now we can see one another.
Say hello to fucking Gandalf.
Well, dinner's served. Sorry, it's not more exciting.
So, Willard, what have you got planned for this evening? Bit of disco dancing?
Gather cards?
Oh, well, actually, I was hoping that Dr. Willard would tell us a little bit more about this place.
Well, we are currently in the kitchen area of the Blackwater Institute.
Oh, Brett, you were supposed to be following us.
During the 1950s, this place was an institute for mental health care of a sort.
An asylum?
Yes, a private facility. It was run by a revolutionary scientist called Blackwater. He was a great thinker, an innovator. He was taking the study of the human mind into whole new spheres of research.
Sounds like a swell guy.
No, he was, for a time. The details are a little sketchy, but it would appear that at some time, I would put it around 1958, 1959, the scientific world of which he had become such a key part turned on him. I suppose he refused to modernize his thinking and so paid the price. No longer taken seriously, Blackwater boarded himself and his patients, all of whom had significant psychological problems, into the asylum. None of his discoveries were ever published in respected journals. By the time the authorities shut him down in 1963, he was a shadow of a man, as tormented as the last of his surviving patients.
And what's that got to do with me?
Well, technically, nothing. The history of this place is merely incidental. What is significant is that the beginnings of your story started here, bringing you back to investigate the reactions of your mind. That is the divine aspect of the research. We will begin tomorrow. We will ask you questions, ask you to relive your experience.
I wasn't listening, just staring into the shadows, wondering where they were hiding. I had to get out of there, I was suffocating.
Excuse me.
I'll go check if he's okay.
I did think about ending it. I'll admit that. Better for everybody. Long run, maybe it would have been. Me dead, they might have just left, but I'm not a quitter. It's something I just couldn't do.
I've spent years trying to get past this. This is dangerous, me being here.
If you really want to leave, I'm sure everyone will understand. Maybe some more therapy wouldn't be such a bad thing.
Back at the Institute?
No. Here, with Dr. Willard. The things you think you saw, they seemed real. Delusions always do. Ghost stories are exactly that, Nick. Stories. Your mind made them up for some reason.
Well, that just makes the truth worse, doesn't it?
When we start the study tomorrow, the truth will come out. Then you can put all of this behind you.
I killed a woman and I can't remember doing it. You don't get a lot of sympathy when that kind of thing happens. Your family and friends ostracize you. They don't want to know you anymore. I spent every day at the Institute trying to piece together what happened, and every day I came up with the same answer that they think. I'm there for the reason they think I am, that I'm crazy. I just can't find the answers. It's just darkness.
Gotta go.
No, don't. Just stay one night. I want to show you something. And if by tomorrow morning you still have doubts, then leave before anyone wakes up, and I won't say a word.
What do you mean?
I have an idea.
Sorry, Willard.
Really, Mr. Wilson?
This is cozy.
Tried my best.
So where's your friend Nick?
Gone for a walk, I imagine.
And where's Rachel?
Keeping company, I think.
Is that safe?
I don't trust him.
No, me neither. Gives me the creeps.
It's been a long day. I think it's time I went to bed.
I'll take you.
Thank you, Melissa. Good night, Brett.
Good night, Willard.
You see now, Dr. Willard, you've been overdoing it.
Nonsense, my dear. I'm as fit as a fiddle.
Well, as long as you let me know, okay?
Have you the list of all my items I require?
Yes,
and they're all in my room. Ah! Nick. Perfect. I'd like to talk to you in private for a moment, if you don't mind.
Where's Rachel?
She's asleep. You don't believe me? Go and check. She's still breathing.
Oh, I didn't say anything. Dr. Willard, I'll just make your room up the best I can.
Thank you. There's something I haven't told others, but I think that you should know. You come with me. I have not been entirely honest with the others. In my book, it is not about you. It is more about what happened. I recently came into possession of Blackwater's private journal. The journal details much of Blackwater's research practice. Makes very disturbing reading. Blackwater was experimenting on his patients, inmates of his asylum, in the most unorthodox ways. Medical practices on the clinically insane were not of a high standard in the 1950s. But Blackwater took his research to a whole new level of depravity, of cruelty. Most of the work concentrated in the basement. That is where the real horror took place. He was ostracized from the scientific world of the time because of his attempt to suggest existence of the human soul.
Why are you telling me this?
Because that's not all the journal details. The purpose of those experiments was connected to the contraption that you say took Sammy.
And that thing didn't take Sammy. I know that now. It was in my head. Rachel told me.
Rachel? Rachel's a student, Mr. West, a good one. But no expert. I am not as convinced of your guilt as you appear to be. Blackwater claimed that the machine he was working on, that thing upstairs, was a portal to another realm. A realm which could separate the soul from the body.
And you believe that?
I believe it's possible. This place is filled with evil. I feel it at every turn. There is a chance that whatever took Sammy still lurks in the darkest corners of this asylum.
So you don't think I'm crazy?
No, Mr. West. But right now, you and I are the only two people in this world who really believe that.
Doctor, I don't know how you think I can help you. You know why? Because they were just delusions!
I don't think so. When dealing with matters of the mind, there is nothing certain. What happened to you 4 years ago was just one in a series of misadventures that have taken place here over the years.
They were all in my head! I know that now! In my head! It had to be.
Did they, Mr. West? I am interested in the answers to a question that no one in my profession dares to ask. What if the crazy person isn't crazy? What if what they're saying is true? And now that we are here, I am in a position to do something about it.
For years I've been told that I was crazy, that I made this whole thing up, and now you're saying that it was true?
Yes, Mr. West.
You're crazier than me.
Everything is in place. Brent and Rachel are my controls. Only they don't know. They are grounded in science. They absolutely will not believe in anything I have just told you. They are an intrinsic part of the study even more than you. So, will you help me, Mr. West?
I don't know.
Then think carefully about what you want. If the journal is accurate, men with a greater reason and will than you have lost their lives to this place.
And just like that, everything you think you know is turned upside down. And nobody is what they seem. They slept too easily. They had no idea. So naive, so innocent. So fucking stupid. And so it began. A young girl with a plan way out of her depth and sinking fast.
Come on.
This is foolish. You don't know what you're doing.
Nick, it's gonna be fine.
Please, Rachel, don't do this.
It's safe here.
It's perfectly safe. And I'm going to prove it to you.
please don't, Rachel.
Nick, I'm going to go and sit down on that chair and you'll see that everything is going to be fine.
Don't!
Nick, it's going to be all right.
But Willard...
What about Dr. Willard?
He told me... I want to believe you, but...
Nick, look at this thing. It's nothing. But Brett sat in it earlier and he's all right. Well, he's a bit of an asshole, but he's always been like that.
Don't sit in that thing, Rachel.
She should have listened to me. They should all have listened to me, but they're too carried away, you see, with their own ideas, wrapped up in educated egos that don't know what I know.
See? There's nothing to be worried about.
Famous last words.
It's a chair, nothing more. What are you so afraid of?
You haven't seen the things I've seen. You don't know what you're dealing with.
What is it that you don't understand? Can't you see, Nick? It's all in your mind.
Sammy.
Dr. Willard!
What is it? What's happening?
It's happened again. Rachel, she's gone through. It's taken her.
Nick.
Why?
So, you think she got sucked into the machine, just like Sammy?
Wait a minute, time out.
I don't know. Maybe. She was trying to help me, I could hear the voices.
Willard, have you been handing out crack pipes?
You have a better explanation for what happened, I suppose.
Well, I'd say it's the insane asylum inmate.
Yeah, in the torture chamber, with whatever murder weapon he used to kill the last girl.
Well, you think I did it?
Well, it's not like you're a nutter or anything.
Show some respect for the patient. Can't you see you're upsetting him with these baseless accusations?
Baseless bollocks.
That's enough!
Nick.
through. I have to bring her back.
Yeah, that's what we've been saying.
Yeah, bring her back. Everything will be fine.
This is the last time I'm going to tell you two to be silent! There are things happening here you can't possibly comprehend. Nick, supposing you do go through, there's no guarantee you'll come back. We don't know what's waiting for you over there.
You shouldn't speak ill of people. What a fucking coward. Room full of triads and big shots, and nobody wants to take responsibility. Time for good old Nick West to step up, eh?
Whatever it is, Rachel's mixed up in it right now. I'm going through.
No!
Stop.
Wait. You'll be no good to Rachel if you can't come back.
What are we gonna do then?
Blackwater's journal. There must be something in there. He built his thing. He knows better than anyone how to work it.
Where is the journal?
It's in my room. Come on.
All right. We'll do your way, old man. But we don't have much time.
£20 says the old man goes missing next.
You think it's Nick?
Of course it is. It's fucking obvious. He's a psycho.
Dr. Willard doesn't think so.
Yeah, well, Dr. Will is as full of shit as Nick is.
Brett, I'm scared.
What? Don't be scared.
What was that?
Fuck all. Who cares?
Wait a minute. I think it came from the chair.
Oh, God, not you as well. It's a chair, for Christ's sake. I sat on that thing earlier and nothing happened. It's bullshit. The whole thing is bullshit.
You sat in it?
Yeah.
Show me.
What?
Show me. Please.
Right, but we carry on from where we left off. I've got a right horn on. See? Nothing.
Brett?
Yeah?
What do you think that's for?
I don't know.
Time for this.
I'm going as fast as I can. Portions of the text are damaged.
You can't build a machine like that and not have some kind of get-out clause.
For Rachel's sake, let's hope not.
Hello? Hello, sailor.
hell is going on?
Shut up, Fred. There is something in here with us.
What? In the closet?
No, you idiot. In this place.
Oh.
It's some kind of a... I don't know. But I think it's after me.
Well, then we should split up.
Come on, old man.
Do you want me to help you or not?
Dr. Willard, it's taken Brett. That thing, it's taken him.
What?
He sat in the chair. He wanted to show me that it was safe.
I know.
He disappeared. I didn't believe you, but you were lying. This is crazy.
That fool. I told him to show more respect for things he does not understand.
Enough of this fucking melodrama.
What are we
going to
do?
I don't know, but we're wasting time here. I'm going through.
Nick!
I'm going through!
Nick! Nick! This is madness! It's suicide!
I don't have a choice. I let Sammy down. I should have gone after her. I'm not going to make the same mistake twice.
Dear boy. If you go through, there's every chance you'll never come back.
Come back to what? This? The Institute? Everything I ever cared about is through there.
There's nothing more I can say.
And take care of yourself, Professor. It's been educational.
There could be anything behind this door.
Right, don't be ridiculous. We need to get out of this place. Just open the fucking door.
All right. Oh, shit, I've cut my hand.
Oh, God.
Thank you.
that?
It's Nick.
What the? Psycho killer?
Fucking idiot. He'd seen the demon, he still wanted to blame me. Some people just get what's fucking coming to them.
Why did you do that?
Where's Rachel?
Who?
Where's Rachel?
She went that way. Remember that way, you cunt.
So that book's supposed to keep you safe?
That's the idea.
Let's have a look. How much blood does this demon need?
A lot. Sorry. The demon must be satisfied.
I told you I'd get her out of that outfit. If only I could get her tits out now.
Thank you.
Turn the volume down, Grandad. What a rotter. As you can see, it all got a bit silly at this point. Girl with her puppies out. Demon. Old banana in pajamas. Is this what I promised you? Are we prick teasing you enough? Are you full up? Is this what you came here to see, oh my brothers?
My gift to you!
Look at this poorly written, badly acted bullshit! Is there any truth in this B-movie banality? No! No! There is no truth, my friends! Believe no one! Believe nothing! I tell you what, party people, you geeks and freaks, you bloodthirsty morons, fuck you. Bring on the red parade!
Get off me, old man. I am not so old. This place. Or we.
So, are there any pulses in the house? You deadbeat, midnight freak, geek-witted, torture-porn gore-horse! I know what you're looking for, so have it, take it, fare thee well, and fuck you very much! Do you ever get the feeling you've been cheated?
But it's killing her! Small price to pay. She'll find her very soon. She set us up. Played directly into my hands. From the very start. Just as I knew. Call it off her.
Call it off her!
She does not answer to me.
But it answers to me.
None of this is real.
Now! Please!
not screaming. Because you're a whore. Genius, Shrinky. You're a fucking goddamn genius.
What?
Of course there's no chair. There never was. Fucking chair. No chair. No chair, Shrinky. Sammy! Sorry I did this. They're all dead now. It's just me and you, Sammy.
It's me.
I've never seen you look so beautiful.
Look at me. It's Rachel.
You look so beautiful.
It's Rachel.
It's just Rachel. Just me and you now, Sammy. That was a bit of fun, wasn't it? And you're not going to tell anyone about this, are you? Trust me, no one's going to believe us. You sure you want to go on the run with a crazy person? Let's go get crazy.
The father to his son says you have to be weak to be strong. Have to be scared to be brave. You have to know fear to be saved. The son to his father says, I'm too scared to be a man. I'm too dumb to be a fool. Father, help me understand. He says, war, 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 war against your soul. Dig, 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 dig your coffin's hole. Everyone must face the demons, and now the turn is yours. It all about? Am I too in to get out? Am I too guilty to be free? Are the whole world sinners or just me? Son, you've got the whole thing wrong. The road is neither short nor long. Answers neither white nor black, and it weighs heavy on your back. Go, 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 go until you're old. Run, 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 run to catch your soul. Every man must learn to love his demon. Your demon's name is yours.